Hello everyone, I'm back with my next video on the story Mother Bear's Call. And the author is Harriet Prescott Spofford. This is the text. As I read the text, I will keep explaining side by side. I hope you enjoy the story. Let us start with the story. Maria from an upper window spied the children coming tugging the basket along. She called down to old uncle and aunt Susan on the piazza. If them children aren't bringing home a cup. Old uncle stirred in his hammock. Aunt Susan went down the steps. What will they do next? Said old uncle. As the twins came up with a joyful outcry to exhibit their treasure, he rose and peered into the basket. It's a cup, surely, he said. He looked at the children from under his shaggy eyebrows. Will you fetch in a catamount tomorrow? He asked sternly. We thought you would be pleased, Essie faltered. So it so happened that Maria saw from the upper window and she saw that the children were bringing a basket along. She called old uncle, Aunt Suzanne on the veranda. Piazza is a veranda. The front veranda is there. And she called the old uncle and Aunt Suzanne. She felt that the children were bringing a cup along in the basket. Old uncle was there lying in his hammock. You can see it in the picture. Aunt Susan quickly rushed down the steps, the stairs that means. And old uncle was really tensed and he asked, now what will they do next? What have they brought? So these twins are these two little girls, Ellie and Essie. And they have brought a basket. When old uncle comes to know, he quickly gets up from his hammock and peers into the basket and he sees that there was a bear cub in the basket. He very sternly and strictly asked the children that what were their plans next? Would they bring a catamount, that is an animal belonging to the cat family or the lion family, the next day? Essie was a little nervous and she said that she had expected old uncle would be very pleased to see the cup. Here the two girls, they are bringing a basket. Inside the basket, there's the baby cub. Why, uncle? Cried Ellie. Why, old uncle, don't you love a baby bear? I just want you to see him suck my fingers. You can't help loving him. I love you, teased uncle, old uncle, catching her up to a place in the hammock beside himself. But you can't keep him alive on your fingers, even if he only sucked up one a day. You are just funning, said Ellie. Pincher knows how to feed him, and so does Michael. I reckon Essie and I could too. Old uncle, we won't let him a bit of trouble, said Essie. Of course, he won't be any trouble, said Aunt Suzanne. She and Aunt Rose had brought a bottle of warm milk with a rag over the top of it. They put it into the little bear's mouth and the whole family gathered round to see him take his dinner. His grunts of satisfaction were very funny. Now it so happened that Ellie, the twin sister of Essie, she asked uncle whether the baby was loving or not, baby bear, and whether uncle liked the baby bear or not. It was so loving, it was so cute and nice to look at. And then she goes on to say that the baby bear used to suck her fingers in a very loving way. So old uncle teased Ellie, he caught Ellie and he made her lie down on the hammock with himself and he says that bears couldn't be kept alive or the bears couldn't survive only by sucking the fingers. even if they sucked one per day. So Ali felt that uncle was joking with her, but she had her own explanations to give. She said that Pincher could feed him, Michael could feed him, and even Essie, her twin sister, knew how to do so. They both also could take good care of the bear. Here in this story, it is not mentioned, but Pincher, I have read this story and all about it. Pincher was a helper in their house, who used to stay in their house and do all the work. Old uncle, we won't let him be a bit trouble. So Essie was so, you know, explanative, and she said that they would take care of the bear and they would not trouble the bear at all. Aunt Susan also liked the bear a lot. It was a very cute little bear, and she and Aunt Rose had brought a bottle of warm milk which was covered with a cloth. They put the milk, the bottle of the milk, in his mouth, the bear's mouth. The bear was really hungry, and they just love seeing the bear drink the milk out of the bottle. His grunts, the sound that he made, showed that he was so hungry, and he was very satisfied by drinking that milk from the bottle. At last, the little fellow let go the bottle, stretched himself, and rolled over on the grass, and looked so good-natured, you could almost have said he was laughing. And Aunt Susan said, "A little bear is a little dear." The cub must have been pretty tired with all the attention and the endearments he received that day, not to say anything about Master Will's efforts to make him stand on his hind legs when he tumbled over every time like a mold of jelly. So it so happened was that when the bear was satisfied by drinking the milk, he let go the bottle and started rolling all over the grass with happiness and satisfaction. Everybody loved seeing this action of the bear. Aunt Susan felt that the bear was very dear. Now the cub was very tired the whole day, getting attentions of the family members of Ali and Essie, and so it was very, very tired, and it wanted, even Master Will, there's this Master Will in their house, he also tried to make the bear stand on his hind legs. Hind legs are the legs at the back. The bear was also very tired. Everybody had shown a lot of affection and had enjoyed with him. Now he was tumbling over just like a mold of jelly. Let's continue. But at last, and after his supper, he was put to sleep in the shed on a little truss of hay under an old blanket, where as soon as he was alone, he began to whimper for his mother. But the children did not hear him. They had trooped upstairs to their own beds, all of them as tired as the cub himself, and were presently sound asleep. So it so happened that after his dinner, he was put to sleep in the shed of the house on the little truss, that is a lot of hay, to make it a cozy bed for him. He was covered with an old blanket to keep him warm. But as soon as he was left alone, all the children, they were tired the whole day playing with the bear. They went upstairs and they were sound asleep. The bear started whimpering because it was remembering its mother. All children, they feel a certain type of love and security when the mother is with them. Here the baby bear was left in the shed alone. He started whimpering for his mother. He was missing his mother. The great moon rose white and solemn above the hills and poured her silver over the forest, and the whole world seemed asleep too. It was just in their first sweet slumber that everyone in that house was waked up by the strangest and the most melancholy, the most frightful sound they had ever heard. Now it was loud, high, shrill. Hoo, hoo, hoo. It came. Now it was a long, low growl. So the children went off to sleep. It was night. The moon rose. It was white and very peaceful and calm moon above the hills. The moonlight could be seen all over the forest and the hilltop. The whole world was asleep. Everything was silent. It was at that time when everybody had gone off to sleep. They were all in slumber. Sweet slumber means sound sleep. When suddenly they heard a very strange, sad sound, which was getting a little frightful. It was a sound of someone crying, someone growling. It was a little frightful, but the sound also seemed to be a sad one. Now again, it was a series of sharp cries like barks. Now it was a roar, and something was knocking about the chairs on the piazzas, scratching at the windows, lumbering down the steps and plowing and plunging over the grass. Something with heavy jaws and coming clap, clap along the front of the house. Finally, it made off clumsily in the direction of the shed and raised such an uproar there that the sky rang with it. So it so happened that the sounds of the growling, sounds of some creature became very sharp. It turned into the sharp cries like barks. It was a roar, and everybody in the house could hear someone knocking the chairs of the front veranda, someone scratching at the windows, someone plowing and plunging over the grass. And then suddenly they saw something, a big creature, move clumsily towards the direction of the shed. And there was such an uproar, there was such a lot of noise, that it seemed the whole sky was ringing with it. Everywhere the sound was echoing. Everyone was out of bed and at the windows. The twins, half hiding behind the curtains in fright, shivered as they saw plainly in the moonlight a big creature standing erect, coughing away at the side of the shed and whining and growling all the more when a little whine and a little yelp answered from within. Pincher saw the children and laughed. He was standing at the window at the other end of the long hall. So it so happened was that everybody in the house, all the family members, everyone got up and they came to the windows to see where the sound was coming from, what was it that was making that sound. The twin girls, Ali and Esse, they were too frightened and they were standing behind the curtains and looking out of the window at the creature that had reached the shed and was whining and growling. This was the sound of crying of the mother bear who was finding the baby bear that she had lost that day. Pincher saw the children and laughed when he saw them hiding behind the curtain and looking out. When the mother bear growled, she whined, she growled, she called for the baby bear. The baby bear also answered from within the shed. It was such a nice sight to see. Here we can see the two girls looking out of the window. Other family members also peeping out of the window to see where the growling sound was coming from. So this is now, Pincher saw the two little twin girls looking out of the window, frightened. It was Pincher who spoke all these words from the side of the mother bear. Let us see what he spoke. "It's mother bear," he called. "Hear her. Where's my little bear?" she's asking. "Where's my baby, you folks? Give him back or I'll eat your babies. Little Bruin, I'm hearing of ye. He wants your mammy, don't you? She's smelled ye all the way here. How am I going to fetch ye out, blessed of, if I know? But I'm going after Fetch Ye. I say, give me my little bear. He's a dreadful bright bear. If you folks only seen him eating off blackberries, you would know how smart he was. Say, I just can't lend him. So these are actually the words spoken in a different accent by Pincher. Pincher was the helper. He spoke in this accent. He was actually trying to imitate, trying to say whatever the mother bear was feeling and whatever the mother bear must have wanted to speak. So he said, he told the little girls that it was the mother bear was searching for the baby, and now she had heard the baby and she had smelled it all the way and had reached here, and she had been fetching the baby for the whole day. And then he tells the small children that the mother bear also seems to say to the people here who have brought the baby bear here to give the baby bear back. And also the mother must have meant to say that the baby bear liked to eat blackberries. This is all what Pincher was interpreting for the two little twins. I've got to get him real fat before we go into winter quarters. How would he get here anyway, ye little scam? Can't I leave ye 5 minutes? Ye was safe asleep in a soft holler. And then when I was wading into the river with a beehive in my arms, so to drown the bees and get the honey off ye go. Don't ye know little bears should mind their mother? Oh, somebody took ye. Brrr, I won't leave so much as their aprons if I can lay paws on them. That is, unless so be it's Ali and Essie, but I'll have to box their ears for them. I guess I say now, folks, brr, brr, I'll tear the place down if you don't give me my cup. Now, as we all know, that Pincher was actually interpreting what the mother bear must have been saying in her own language to the people, to the world who have brought her son here. She has been finding, fetching her baby the whole day long, and now she has smelled and reached their house. And Pincher goes on to say that the mother bear must be saying that she has to take her baby from here before it starts getting very cold and it starts snowing. They have to go into the hole, into their house. And actually, if you all know that bears, they hibernate. Whenever it is very cold and snowy, these bears go into hiding, and that is known as hibernation. So Pincher says this, and then he goes on to say that the mother bear was saying that I went to fetch honey for the both mother and the baby bear. Honey is liked by these bears. They love eating honey. And so he says that the mother bear must be saying that if when I went to get honey from the beehive, and he was going into the river to remove the bees from the beehive so that he could bring home, the mother bear could bring home the honey for the baby bear. It was at that time the baby bear came out of the hole, and Ali and Essay, they brought him here. Pincher also said that the mother bear must be very angry and must be wanting to box Ali and Essay and to hold their aprons with his paw. And then he feels that the mother bear must be threatening too, that the mother bear would tear the place down if she did not get her cub back. Here we can see the mother bear looking at the beehive. There's a bee inside. Oh, Pincher, does she say all that? Asked Ali. Pincher, would she tear the house down? Cried Essie. The poor mother, Aunt Suzanne was exclaiming, hurrying into her dressing gown and slippers. And then she and old uncle ran down the back way, followed by Pincher, and they took up the cub and opened the shed door a crack and pushed him through and banged and bolted the door behind him. So right now, the mother bear was growling and was very angry at the people who had brought her baby here. She loved her baby a lot. She wanted her baby back. So when Pincher interpreted the mother bear's words, the two little twin girls were very afraid, very frightened and scared. And they were afraid if the bear would tear their house. Aunt Suzanne was the first person. She quickly, you know, hurried down. She quickly wore her dressing gown and slippers and went down. Old Uncle and Pincher also went with her. They went through the back way into the shed and quickly took up the cub, opened the shed towards that side where the mother bear was growling and finding the baby, and they quickly moved or pushed the baby out of the shed and quickly bolted the door. They quickly closed the door so that the mother bear would not attack their house or the shed. Everybody looked out that good. The mother bear stood off a moment on her hind legs. Then she fell on the cub like an avalanche and held him in her arms as any mother holds her baby, and licked him from top to toe and lay down and gave him dinner. After that, gazing back at the house every step or two with a growl, she lurched off, little Bruin laboriously following. So it so happened was that when the baby bear was pushed out of the shed by Aunt Suzanne and Uncle, the mother bear was very happy to get her baby back. She stood on her hind legs and she was very happy to see the baby. And then she fell on the cub, on her baby, just like an avalanche. What is an avalanche? It is a big slab or arrival or a mass of ice that rapidly falls down from the mountain side. And in the same way, you know, she was overwhelmed and she plunged and fell on and quickly hugged the baby bear to protect him and held him close to her arms as any mother could hold her baby very tightly. She licked him from top to toe and she gave him his dinner. And after that, she very angrily gazed at the house. She growled at the house to show her anger to the people who had brought her baby here, and then took little Bruin away. Little Bruin had to work a lot and follow the mother. Here we can see how the two are meeting. The mother bear is meeting the baby bear. But Pincher declared that last he saw, as he wanted her out of sight, she was up on her hind legs carrying her baby in her arms like anybody. The twins watched as long as they could see her. Then Essay began to cry. "I wanted to keep him," she said. I loved him so. So Pincher told everybody that he saw the mother bear hold the baby bear on her very lovingly in her arms and was walking on her hind legs, as we can see in the picture. Essie was very upset. She began to cry because she just loved the baby bear and wanted to keep it. "So did I," said Ellie with her arms around Essie. "But I guess, Essie, we'll have to get along with Boo Boo." "I wondered how Pincher knew his name was Bruin. Someday we'll go into the woods and call Bruin, Bruin, and perhaps he will remember us. His mother loved him, you know, Essie. I suppose she was sorry when she found him gone. Mothers must have their babies, and you know, Essie, why, they belong to them." "If you foolish children don't go to sleep," cried Uncle Billy from some remote quarter, "I'll call Mother Bear back." "Oh, do you believe you could?" answered Ellie. "Oh, Uncle Billy, I wish you would." So it so happens that Essie started crying. Ellie comes to her twin sister. She tries to console her sister. And they talk a lot about Bruin. They wonder how did Pincher know the baby bear's name. They also feel that if they would go into woods one day and call Bruin Bruin, will the baby bear remember these two kids? And Elle goes on to tell Essay that all the mothers, they love the children a lot. And she talks about the mother bear, and she tells that mother bear must have felt very bad when she found that her baby bear was lost. And it was the mothers, and it was a fact that mothers need their babies and the babies need their mothers. It is the most secure place for a baby to be with the mother. When these two children were discussing, they were remembering Bruin and they were talking to each other. Uncle Billy heard these two children talking and they were not sleeping. He gets angry. He shouts from his room and tells them to go back to sleep. Otherwise, he would call the mother bear back, who was very angry at these two children. Ellie answers back, if Uncle Billy could really call the mother bear back, they would be able to meet the baby bear again. And here we end with the story. I hope you like the story. Let's go on to see what is next. I'm here with question and answers for you. Let us quickly read the questions and the answers. What did everyone in the family do when they saw the children bringing a bear cub? The answer is, when everyone in the family saw the children bringing in a bear cub, they were surprised. Maria announced it to the family. Aunt Susan came downstairs and old uncle stirred in his hammock. He commented on the cub's diet and it could not be kept alive on mere fingers. Mere means only fingers. Question 2. How did Aunt Susan and Aunt Rose treat the bear cub? The answer is, Aunt Susan and Aunt Rose treated the bear cub with love. They brought him a bottle of warm milk for his dinner and fed him as the family gathered around to watch. Question 3. Why did Aunt Susan say, a little bear is a little deer? Aunt Susan said, a little bear is a little deer because after having his dinner, the bear cub stretched himself, rolled on the grass and looked so good-natured that it seemed that he was laughing. Question 4. Where was the bear cub put to sleep? What happened after he was left alone? The bear cub was put to sleep in a shed on a little truss of hay under an old blanket. After he was left alone, the bear cub began to whimper for his mother. Question 5. Why could the children not hear the cub whimpering? The children could not hear the bear cub whimpering because they had gone to their beds and were sound asleep. Question 6. What was the reaction of the family as they heard the uproar? When the family members heard the uproar, they woke up, got out of their beds and rushed to the windows to look outside. What did Pincher tell the children? Pincher told the children that Mother Bear was desperately looking for her cub. She was demanding the family to give him back or she would eat their babies. She had smelt her cub all the way to the shed. The cub was very smart, according to his mother. He only ate blackberries. The mother bear could not lend him for she wanted to get him fat before they went into hibernation. Then she scolded the cub that he could not stay in the hole for even 5 minutes. She had gone to get him honey when he was taken by the children. She threatened the family that she would not leave so much as their aprons if the cub was not returned to her, and she would box Ellie and Essay's ears for good measure. She would also tear down the place if they did not let her cub go. Question 8. How did Mother Bear feel when she saw her cub? When Mother Bear saw her cub, she seemed relieved and ecstatic. Ecstatic is very excited and happy. She stood off on her hind legs for a moment. Then she fell on the cub like an avalanche, held him in her arms and licked him from top to toe. Reference to context questions. The first extract is, what will they do next? Question A is, who said these words? Where was the speaker? Old uncle said these words. He was on a hammock. Question B. Who does they refer to? The answer is, they refers to the twins, Ale and Esse, in the above lines. Question C. What had they done? They had brought a bear cub home. Extract 2. The poor mother. Who said these words? Answer is, Aunt Suzanne said these words. Question B. Who is the poor mother? What was she doing? Answer is, Mother Bear is the poor mother. She was roaring and growling in search of a little cub. Question C. What did the speaker do with the bear cub? Answer is, Aunt Suzanne let the bear cub go. She took the cub, opened the shed door, a crack, and pushed him through. Question 3. Extract 3. If you foolish children don't go to sleep, I'll call Mother Bear back. Question A. Who is the speaker? Uncle Billy is the speaker. Question B. What were the children doing? Answer is, the children were talking about Mother Bear and Little Bruin. Question C. What was the reply given when they heard the above words? The answer is, when they heard the above words, the children asked Uncle Billy if he could really call Mother Bear back and that they wished he would. There is just one extra question. Let us quickly see it. Do you think children should have brought home the bear cub? Let us see the answer. No, the children should not have brought the bear cub home because it is wrong to separate children from their mothers. Mother Bear could best care for Little Bruin and no human home could provide him the warmth, comfort and security that his mother could give him. It is mentally and emotionally very painful for both a mother and a child to get separated, and we should not be the reasons why someone goes through that kind of heart-wrenching pain. I hope you have understood each and every answer. If you have not understood, please write it in the comment section so that I can get back to you. If you are a newcomer and you have still not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel, press the bell icon for the latest notifications. Also watch all my other videos. Do take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.